What is pseudo-archaeology? So what is pseudo-archaeology? That's easy. It's fake. So the word pseudo-archaeology means fake archaeology, right? And how this works is it's based on magical thinking, right? So what we're doing here is we're going to talk about something like Atlantis. Was there ever an Atlantis? No! No, not even a little bit. There's no Atlantis. But that is a horrendous bummer, is it not? But your magical thinking wants there to be an Atlantis, because Atlantis plays to your feelings. You know, do you want there to be an Atlantis? Hell yeah. Do I want there to be an Atlantis? Hell yeah. But is there an Atlantis? Hell no. But it's a bummer, right? But that's what real archaeology does, right? We're going to focus on the facts. We have to go based on what we can prove, not just what we would like to have happen. You know, what we would like there to be. You know, aliens would be great. Is there any evidence of aliens? No! Okay? That's what pseudo-archaeology is. So, it's fake. How do people who play this game, you know, the ancient aliens crowd and this kind of thing, how do they pull one over on you? First, they're going to boldly state their lies, right? They're not going to go like, well, you know, maybe it depends. You see, here we find this. They don't do that. They just go like, oh, this is what it's like. You know, you've probably heard them. They'll use terms like, well, you know, everybody knows. Yeah, do they? No, they don't. Well, you see, it's been proven. No, it hasn't. Right? They'll start with those lines to pull you in. So they aren't half-assing their lies, right? Their lies are just like, hey, this is facts that everyone knows. No, it's not, right? So, of course, if you're going to push bold-faced lies, you have to then cut out the legs from academic archaeologists like me, right? You have to go with, oh, well, you see, academic archaeology is so flawed. You'll hear this, I guarantee you, within the first minute if you're listening to a pseudo-archaeologist talk. Well, you see, academic archaeology, you see, they're so narrow-minded. They're so close-minded. They aren't open to the truth. You'll hear something. Crap like that, right? So somebody like me, who spent their whole life getting advanced degrees, learning all they can learn, really searching for facts and spending the time, I'm somehow narrow-minded. And you know why I'm narrow-minded? Because I throw the facts in their face and show them that they're full of crap, so they have to cut my legs out. You will hear them double down on this, like as they talk, they'll be like, well, you see, but the academics, they've long argued this, and they're just lying, right? They're just full of it, but they're playing to your feelings. Beware, right? Facts over here, feelings over here. I play the facts game. They play the feelings game, and the feelings game is powerful, my friends. So you have to watch it, right? Every time I say there's no Atlantis, aren't you like, shut up, egghead. I know there's gotta be, right? You want one, but there's not. So, what else? Oh, to make you feel good, they will also give you the feeling of like, you're a hero just for listening to them. They'll say something like, well, thank God that you have an open enough mind to listen to me, to go down this path with me. Not like those closed-minded archaeologists over there. You're open. You know, you are bold, my friend. And so we together will talk about the factual reality of Atlantis. You see, that's coaxing you in, right? I want to do that. But it's not the hard road and the factual road and the true road, right? It's fake. When you see these people, again, they will operate on those ideas that I've already listed. They will not be scientific. They will be shunned by the scientific community, right? They just won't be, they won't be a part of my world because they have no credentials. That's another thing. They'll have no credentials. And what's funny, when you see them on TV, it'll never say Dr. So-and-so, or if it does, it's some like fake doctorate. But instead of calling them like professor or archaeologist, they'll call them like explorer, researcher, you know, something that like makes them seem, they always, for all the complaining they do about academia, they always try and make themselves academics. They always give themselves titles, right? They talk about their titles more than I do. I don't talk about my title that much because my title's real. I'm a doctor of archaeology, and I took years and years working in the jungle, day in, day out, month in, month out, learning facts about the Maya world because I was so excited to bring facts to the general public and to the rest of the world. Not just for show, not just to come up with some mystery. That's another thing that pseudoarchaeologists do. They look for mysteries, they gin up mysteries. Why do they deal with mysteries? Because it sounds good. It plays to your wants and your feelings, right? There's no data game in mysteries. Mysteries of the unexplained. Mysteries of the unknown, right? And you want to watch that. I get that. I get why you'd want to see that. I want to see that. And that brings me to my final point with the media. And I will say that pseudo-archaeologists, they play the media game well. They play it better than most academic archaeologists, honestly, because pseudo-archaeologists are into this game. What you will see is these people who purport to be, you know, explorers or whatever it is, researchers, theorists. They present themselves almost as college professors. Like, many of these people look more like a cliche college professor than me, but I'm a real one, right? They will have button-down shirt, little glasses on, kind of unkempt hair. Your idea of what a college professor is, they're going to exploit that, right? And so just seeing them look like that, you go, oh, they must know what they're talking about. They look college-y professor-y, right? Well, look at me. I don't really fulfill that cliche. I just hope that my facts speak for themselves. But the media, they don't play that game, right? The media is just looking for the 30-second soundbite. The other thing the media will do, and the media are a bit culpable, they will take a pseudo-archaeologist, like these people who are just full of it, pushing onto your wants and needs, and they'll take me, and they'll have some sort of head-to-head, right? They'll call it some sort of, you know, point-counterpoint, making it seem like it's somehow even, that it's somehow 50-50. The pseudo-archaeologist fake huckster, and then the real archaeologist who has knowledge and facts, and they make it seem like it's 50-50. It's not. It's 100% zero. I know things, right? I have facts. And I know that sounds like I'm, like, talking highly about myself, and it feels weird, and it feels uncomfortable, but it's true, and pseudo-archaeologists use that against you. Remember, they state their lies boldly. Everyone knows that there's an Atlantis. No, they don't. Well, it's been proven that there's an Atlantis. No, it hasn't. Right? So remember that. Don't get sucked in. We as archaeologists, though, can take a note from the pseudo-archaeology world in dealing with the media. You know, it does behoove us to make interesting shows, to give as many interviews with the general public, to talk to the general public as much as we can, to use normal words, don't use a bunch of jargon that turns people off, right? And tell the true story of the past, because that is what it's about. And just shun all that BS, because the true story of the past is by far the more interesting story. Facts are fantastic.